So welcome back to another video. We're going to be using just three brushes for this one. This is Skoda. This is a Versatile number 6. We're going to be using the smaller number 2. I've got the mop brush there. That's about a number 8 mop brush. I said 3, but I meant 4. And finally, just about number 12 round. Now then, first things first, we're going to get plenty of clear water and get the sky in. Just going to put some clear water in to the sky, just come down over the horizon. Going to keep this sky really, really simple. It's just ultramarine. Just going to let the paint do the work. I'm going to mess around. Pop in some more water. Let that come all the way down. Let it come in. Doing that, we have a bit of a runoff there, so we can get rid of that runoff. Not too happy with that. I'll just change the angle. We'll pop in some raw sienna. Just as an underpainting. Plenty of liquid. Doesn't matter if it's running over there. Then I'm going to mix up a slight grey mix, grey blue mixture, keep it quite light, and put in this path. There. Oh, the birds are having a go at each other. And that's kind of it. To start with. Nice and simple. Popping a bit more grey in here. Just wait for it to dry. Could take a while. So this is almost dry and I'm going to go into stage 2 or step 2 of the painting. I'm going to start from the back, work away forward. Just going to take the round brush for this. Just test. Yep, that's dry very quickly. Ultramarine again. Let's pop that in. I have some variation in this as well. Just cool that off a bit. Comes forward. Warming it up as we come forward a bit more. And we'll have sort of a green brown coming in here. Just bring that forward a bit more. Brush, take all of this, in a bit more ultramarine. Touch of this orange. It's like a warm sort of grey. Don't need to be too careful and too precise with it. And the value stronger as we come forward. Three colours there, ultramarine, touch of Payne's grey, touch of burnt umber. Just go carefully around here. Just drop in some water, clear water, along the bottom there, just to run that off. Relatively clear water. Just so it blends and bleeds. Here comes the sun. Same mixtures. Bit of cadmium yellow. And these are shapes and blocks, and values really. Just running that outlook. That's the sienna. Touch of ultramarine. In there. Warm this up with burnt umber. Just take this off, it's all running away there. I just want to sort out the end of the road where it vanishes. Some tissue. And bleed the eye into the paint and that. It's drying very quickly. Gonna go darker now. Same colours, ultramarine, burnt umber. Squeeze some of that off. Just touching these darker notes. Painting by numbers, it's popping size. Give some water to run off. Some blue in here. Some blue in that. Let's try and sort that splish out the sky. it back up so it goes back up the other way. There we are. Clear water again. Just to soften those edges. Some of it's dry. Distance, I'm going to take kind of purple, so it's a Lazarin crimson. Call it Lizarin, whichever way you want to say it. Touch it. Ultramarine. Just going to come in here. Just to warm up. So it runs up the other way. A touch of that, just coming all the way down. Nice and warm. Add in shadow colours. I'll just clear all this out. And we'll wait for the next part. So, getting near the end of this video. And before I put the shadows in, I'm just going to put in a few details, some dry brush work. This is a number 6 Escoda. Keeping it nice and light. And we don't want to go over all these pencil marks, that would be daft. It's not painted by numbers. But it's quite good just to pick out some highlights. You have to be careful here. I'm going to put in some clear water there. Don't like that too much. I'll take that out. Tissue. Just too wet, that's all. Just get drier. Splayed out brush. How I'm holding the brush to the end, not close up. I encourage you to paint in a more loose fashion. Need to make that mixture a bit darker by adding some blue. Touching a few of these pencil marks, really. Not many. A bit of dry brush there, like. You see, it's easy to overdo this. So, I suggest the edge of the path, verge. The road, whatever that is. Going off there. Probably make the foreground ones a little bit darker. In spots. Just taking the eye back. Just putting a few. send everything back. Darker still. Some twigs or leaves or parts of a branch coming over. Use the other brush for this, a bit finer detail. Again, holding it near the end. Because we're outside, everything dries off quite quickly, the paint does, on the palette as well as on the paper. Suggestions. Touching some green stuff back there. Kind of done. And all this. Just want to get some darker edges here. Pull all this forward. And then we'll pop in some shadows in a second. Just kind of picking out a few little details. The impression of distant mountains. This is the sort of closest to us, so we see more detail. These I'm going to leave quite sparse. Yeah. And then we're just going to pop in finally. Slightly, it would be quite nice to run that out. A bit of a shadow in a second. Bring in some shadow here. The mixture for that tends to use cobalt blue, cerulean blue, a touch of crimson. Get a nice little shadow cover. Just warm this up. Put in a few more quick shadow colours in here, and we're almost done. Shadow coming across, same colour. One more. It's kind of tying everything up. But that's just about done. That's it. Except it's never quite done, is it? We always add another little bit. Just along here. There we go. It'll come a bit darker down here. Shadow colours are basically cobalt blue, goes on crimson, and I touched in a little bit burnt sienna, burnt umber, just to warm that up. And that's it, kind of done. So when this is dry, we'll take off the mask and tape, and that's it. Impromptu mountain scene. I'll just put in a couple of these scratches. Can't go too mad, but they're quite good for highlights. Done. So here we go, the moment of truth, the ta-da moment. I'm taking off tape, masking tape, to reveal finished painting. Northeastern Highlands in Scotland. Turned out very nicely. So thanks for joining me. Remember to like, to subscribe, and I'll see you again next time. Take care and happy painting.